Welcome to our garage, our home, where we live, myself, Katherine Brunt.
Boulder, 2-2 for Brunt.
And Natalie Sciver.
Beautiful shot from Nat Sciver.
And today we're going to be doing a home workout, appropriate for any cricketers, or just anyone in general, really. So first we're going to do a warm-up. It's really important to get your body ready for your session.
Right, laying on your back, heels up to your butt, and we're just going to rotate from side to side. And you're going to look to get in at least 10 each side, but feel free to do more if you're feeling extra stiff. And then we'll move into a variation of that where you just put your feet apart, but your knees together, and then rotate the knee inwards, keeping your feet on the ground. Reps wise, same again, 10 on each side. And then we're going to our last one, feet together, and we're just going to roll side to side again, but with the foot coming out. So we roll to one side, foot comes out. Roll to the other side, foot comes out.
So next we're going to go through some hamstring mobility. Obviously a big muscle group within the body and important for us. So we're going to start by laying on our backs and just holding the back of your knee and just extending your leg out. We'll just start slow with this so you don't need to go too aggressive too early, and then once your hamstring feels a bit more warm, you can go into a straight leg raise. So again, about 10 on each leg, and you're just wanting to scan your body, see if there's any stiff bits, and obviously focus a little bit more on that area if you do have any. We'll do some hip flexor stretching and hip mobility. So just get into this position and then push your hips forward, and you can either stay there or just lunge into it a little bit, and then to increase it, you raise your hand above your head and get that stretch along here, and really stretch your hip flexor in here.
And then the final one is just like out to the side, everything's in line here, and you're just going to lean back into it, and you should feel it all around the inside of your leg at the top and all around your glute. Just do as many of them as you see fit. I normally need a good 6 to 10 to get me going. Yeah. Right, and then we'll move on to some activation. This is the bit that like no one likes to do, so it's got to be done. You can't just jump into a heavyweight session and then expect to be okay. We're going to do glutes specifically. Obviously, bowlers like me with a massive shelf, you want to generate some power through your glutes. So we're going to start with some clams. So Nat takes this band, which you can get these bands anywhere now online, literally anywhere, and they're very inexpensive. So I would recommend getting one if you're an avid cricketer. If you can't get one for any reason, then you can just use whoever you've got around, your parents or your family members, and they can literally just resist you without the band. So Nat's going to do it with the band. And a few of those reps, making sure you stay with your heels in line with your butt, and making sure this doesn't rotate out, it stays firm and you're working from the hip.
And you do what, 10 reps on each side?
Yeah, until you feel a burn, 10 reps on each side.
You might feel a burn after one then.
You feel a burn after one, you're in problems. We like to do this in our pre-game warm-up actually. You're just gonna keep your feet about shoulder width apart, and you're just gonna go out, don't bring your feet together, keep them separated. And it generally only takes about 5 each side before you feel a really good burn in your butt. Keep your knees slightly bent. And that's the warm up.
Okay, let's get into the session. We're gonna start with the lower body.
Here's exercise number one, the front squat. The front squat is really great in cricket, whether you're batting, bowling or in the field. And we want to generate as much power and strength as we can through the bottom half, through the full range of movement. So when you're doing it, look to get quite deep in the squat. Technique wise, obviously a front squat is held at the front, and you're going to get your elbows up quite high. Obviously if they're low, the bar will drop forward. And then as you're coming down, you're looking to sit back and not push forward with your knees. So it's not sitting back nice. And you want to keep this back as straight as possible. Try not to stick your butt out too much. You want to keep that tailbone tucked under. and keeping a strict form. I recommend, you know, getting the strictest form with the most amount of depth with a suitable weight.
In the past, I've done up to 8 to 10 reps and 3 sets, but at the moment I'm doing 3 sets of 5. So it's really up to you. Here's a variation of the front squat. This is the single leg squat. Can be done to a bench or a sofa or whatever you've got in your home. And Katherine's using a rock at the moment as her weight, but that can be substituted for anything. But just similar reps to the front squat, just making sure that your knee doesn't have too much movement. It's as stable as possible, as Katherine's demonstrating.
Exercise number 2 is the Nordic. This helps to build strength and robustness in your front leg, especially when seen bowling.
I'm going to start in this position, holding Katherine's ankles down, and Katherine's just going to hinge forward from her knees and slowly lower to the floor and then push herself back up.
I'm going to try.
There you go. So in that exercise, we're looking for a flat back again, not sticking her butt out, like she said before, and making sure that the hamstrings are the things that's working.
Right, exercise number 3, the calf raise. It builds some shock absorption, great for bowlers who land heavy, especially fast bowlers. With weight in hand, she's just going to dip up and down with her foot quite far off of the ledge. And she's going to go down and up with a 2-second motion. So down 2, up 2. It's important to go slow so that you can really feel the burn in your calf and you don't have to do as many reps. If you're struggling for something to use, you can use the stairs at your house, which is great. And also for a weight, if you don't have a dumbbell, just pick up a paint can, 10 litre, 5 litre, don't matter. It just depends on how strong you are, obviously. And use that as your weight aid.
We've done our lower body exercises, now we're going to move on to the upper body. Let's do it. We're going to do the bent over row. Katherine's going to use a weight here, but it can be your paint can or anything else you can find around your house. It's important to have strength around your shoulder for throwing and bowling as well. We're going to look to do about 8 to 10 reps and 3 sets. So as Katherine does it, she's going to lift up gently, not really drag it up as fast as you can, but keeping your core tight, keeping your back flat as well, and then just lift up so your elbows around level with the rest of your body. We're going to do our bench press. Obviously with this setup we can do this here. It's a very important power exercise for all parts of cricket, really. Batting, bowling, fielding, just having that strength to do what you want to do powerfully. So Katherine is very strong, so she can probably do about 10 reps of this, but it depends what weight you've got. We're also going to show you a variation if you don't have this. If she, as she lowers it, really it wants to be on the mid-chest line, up and down on the same line, to make it easier for you. And having your core tight is also very important, making sure your back stays in place. A variation to the bench press if you don't have a setup like this. You can lie on the floor, as Katherine's demonstrating, and then press any heavy object that you've got around the house. We've got a rock.
And she's going to be careful when she passes it to me. Safety first. Here's an overhead shoulder press. While we're doing cricket, obviously want to keep going with the strength and condition that we need for our shoulders so that we can throw multiple times a week and we can bowl loads of overs. So getting that conditioning in the shoulder and the strength that we need. Nat's just going to show you a few reps. Technical points to look out for. Make sure we keep our elbow in line with our shoulder. Keeping a vertical back. Keep that tailbone tucked under in a nice strong position. And do about 8 to 10 reps, 3 sets.
Last but certainly not least, we're going to do our core circuit. Exercise number 1, the rollouts. This is very important for our core and abdominal muscles, which in cricket is very important for all skills.
We picked one of these up real cheap, like £5, from one of our local stores, and extremely easy to assemble. So grab yourself one because it's great. Nat's just going to show you. So the technical points is I would recommend starting off pretty shallow to start, so don't go out too far. You'll find yourself you can't get back up. And then work your way out to where you think your capability is. So Nat can probably reach full length as demonstrated. Ooh, back up she goes. But yeah, I would recommend taking it easy, find your range and look to improve week on week. And this will be really great in this front section here and in your deep core.
Now we're going to move on to the side hold. It can be done on the bench or on the sofa inside if you need to. Katherine's going to line herself up on the end of the bench with her hips, and then when I lean on her legs, she's going to lift her hand up and hold for about 30 to 40 seconds, and we'll do 2 to 3 reps.
Here's the parlof press. We do a lot of band work in cricket, and they're really easy to pick up from anywhere online. Quite cheap these days, they're very popular. So technical points, I'd keep a really good resistance on the band to their capability. I'm just looking to push it forward and up above the head. So we're looking for a straight back and a slight bend in the knee, and we're pushing forward and up above the head.
Other variations you can do with the band, you can do a rotation like this, or above your head for bowlers, and then a vibration one for your core. Then to make it harder, your partner can move the band and you still have to stay stable within your core and make sure she can't move you. And that's us done in the gym. Now it's time to refuel and rehydrate. Make sure you get lots of water and some food in there, especially some protein.
Thanks for joining us at home. Go and give it a go, and most importantly, have some fun. See ya.